Ladles and jelly spoons, welcome back to Badgerworks. Today, this is another Star Wars vehicle. In this case, the First Order Special Forces TIE fighter from The Force Awakens. Now, you may recall in the previous video, I did the X-Wing in RAF colours. And so, perhaps unexpectedly, this one is going to be done in Luftwaffe colours. So, let's have a look in the box and see what we've got. God, it's huge. Right. Once again, just talk amongst yourselves for a minute. God, how these things are made for kids is a mystery. Right. Let's have a look. Cockpit. Again, it has the... Oh, it's got an LED in it. There's an LED in there, look. So I suppose when it's all boxed up, it lights up the cockpit when you press the button. Okay. Let's pop that back in there for a minute. If it will go back in. There we go. This is huge. But then I suppose it would be. But yeah, it's a monster. I don't even see that, but these solar panel, are they solar panels? Are a bit warped. What I might have to do is put those on something and put a bit of weight on them to try and flatten them out a bit. Yeah, so it's the same deal as before. It's molded in a couple of colors and then, just has some coloured bits stenciled on it. So, yeah. Okay. I'm going to do the same as I did with the last one. I think I'm going to paint this in pieces and then put it together afterwards because I think it's a lot easier doing that with these. So, yeah, let's get on with it. Right, now one other thing I've got to consider are decals. I don't really have any much in the way of like German decals, but I have got a few bits. This is from a Revell Hawk, Red Arrow's Hawk, and it's got the Swiss markings, but all of these bits are all in German, so they'll probably do. A couple of Maltese crosses, I don't actually know what they're from. And I've also got these, which came off of one of the Edward Eindeckers that I built, so they might be of use. The other thing, these ones are from the Eurofighter build, the Italeri, I can never say that word, Eurofighter, so I can probably use those if I need to. The other thing I've got is this. This is actually for a Thunderjet, Aeromaster aftermarket decals, and I was wondering whether this here might go round the top of the windscreen. So I'll try that and see if that fits. But the other thing I've thought of doing, which is probably more suitable, as far as the wings, the solar panels on the side go, I might actually try and stencil and put on a couple of big Maltese crosses and actually paint them on. We'll see what that looks like. Thank you. And here is the finished article. I'm quite pleased with how this has come out, actually. It was quite a tricky thing to do. The main problem was translating the colour scheme from an aircraft that has horizontal wings onto an aircraft that has vertical wings. But I think it's come out alright. I think it looks nice. And it gives the idea, that's the main thing. So yeah, now we have our RAF X-Wing and our Luftwaffe TIE fighter. So yeah, just a little flight of fancy, nothing too amazing. So yeah, I hope this has been of interest to some of you, and I look forward to seeing you in the next video. Thanks very much for watching. Cheers. Bye.